And incidentally, continually produces results, even though in county games it has the reputation of being a very flat pitch. England beat Australia by an innings and 118 runs. So a terrific performance from the England side.
Just one of those things you have no control over.
Final test match at the Oval. Well, a long time ago they made a film about the final contest of a series between England and Australia, and that was full of excitement and drama. I wonder if this one here over the next 5 days will be able to match it. Well, certainly the conditions couldn't have been better this morning. Beautiful sunshine, a temperature forecast of around about 22 degrees. You couldn't have asked for more, particularly as the pitch looked to be very hard and firm, and I reckon there'll be a little bit of bounce in it, certainly on the first day. The teams, well, Ian Botham got through his fitness test this morning. Athey was made 12th man and Agnew left out. So it's the same side there as Edgbaston. Australia, three changes. In comes Dirk Wellham in the middle of the batting order. In comes Murray Bennett and Dave Gilbert. Four byes have been registered in the very first over. It's the first ball of the second over. McDermott is coming into bowl to Tim Robinson.
To Robinson, the first run going up for the batsman. I think Australian supporters and viewers would like to forget McDermott's bowling in the last test match when he had an off match, but that apart, he's got a remarkable record already. It's only his eighth test match, he's collected 36 wickets. And he comes in now to Gooch. And that's his problem, as it was there. An over-pitch ball on the leg stump. And both Gooch and Robinson are very powerful in that area. It was estimated that about 80% of England's runs came on the leg side up at Birmingham, making that very big total. Straight through Robinson's defence, good fast Yorker knocking back the off stump, and England lose Robinson with 20 on the board. He goes bowl McDermott for three, and the early wicket that Australia were looking for. You could see that ball swinging in, and swinging in quite late, and that's always the danger with the swing ball. If it swings all the way, it's easy to pick up. This one in fact seemed to come in quite late in its flight. Knocked back the off stump, and a rare failure there for Tim Robinson. Well, as you would expect, there'll be an array of slips and gullies for David Gower at the start of his innings. Stroked away quite beautifully. Lovely, an elegant shot there as ever from Gower to see him safely away. Picks up two for it. It completes Dermot's over.
So Australia and England level pegging here. England 23 for one. And the quick bowlers going pretty well, but a change at the top end and a debut for the new young Australian bowler, Dave Gilbert.
There the first runs off him. Gooch was aiming it away square of the wicket on the offside. Might be an indication that he is a little quicker than he appears, that the ball flew a little finer than that. It's a very good delivery. It escaped the clutches of Border and Ritchie and Wood and everyone else who was rushing back. That was very well bowled by McDermott.
Gower in all sorts of trouble. One hand off the bat. He doesn't know where the ball's gone. It's just lobbed over the despairing chase of Alan Border.
No ball and four. Just adding a little bit of insult to the injury. 50 comes up for England, 52 for one. And Gower has already caught Gooch.
And Lawson from the pavilion end to Graham Gooch. That's a lovely shot, through it off. It'll race away for four runs. That's catchable level. A couple of gullies there, and could well have been curtains for David. That's the opposition balcony there. Shot of Ian Botham. Goes four for it, but I don't think David Gower will be over-thrilled about that one. That ball came onto him a lot quicker than he imagined it would. Oh, that's wafted through there again. No third man, it's four runs. There we go again, taking life in his hands.
The trouble with this shot, it's neither a cut nor a defensive stroke. It's just a little push away from the body with the bat angled, and it keeps floating through that area. But it's almost as though David Gower said, well, there's nothing I can do about this shot. It's just part of me. It gets me some runs and it gets me out occasionally.
McDermott coming back at this pavilion end. And on in place of Lawson. He fairly lashed into that. Put nowhere near it. And no third man once again. So David Gower probably thinking this is his lucky day. And this is a bowler we haven't seen on the Test match scene before. This is Murray Bennett, one of the changes in the Australian lineup today. Gooch to face. And just help that round the corner. And going to be one short of 100 so far. That takes him under 99. We haven't in this series on the first day had 100 scored before lunch. 96 from the Australians in the first test. It's the best. It's going to make certain the hundreds up by lunchtime. A legitimate sweep this time from Graham Gooch. Brings up a single, brings England exactly on to 100 at lunch. 100 for one, the wicket to go down, that of Tim Robinson.
That's a great start for England, and both Gower and Gooch were looking in commanding form up to that luncheon score of 100 for one. We pick up play now in the very third over after lunch. Four runs have been added. Craig McDermott, who bowled with plenty of pace in the first session, is coming in now. Taking strike is Graham Gooch.
And that's beaten mid-off. Fielditch in pursuit. There'll be an easy three. Might even get to the rope, which it does. Four more to Gooch.
Bennett to Gower. Gower's just sizing up the left arm spinner. Sized him up to the extent of realizing there's no man at long on. That's a good shot.
century for David Gower. Already's in good touch. 50 from 64 balls, 7 boundaries. It's his 26th half century and he's hit 1100s as well. And he's having a terrific season against the Australians. Well placed. Perfectly positioned for the stroke. And he hit it with precision straight between the two men on the offside. Graham Gooch goes to 52.
Gilbert to Gower. Lovely forcing shot off the back foot by Gower for four. Gower at his very best there. Been lucky so many times with the weather here at the start of the Oval Test. It's another lovely day. Sort of day that everybody's been waiting for such a long time. Bennett then to Gooch. That's the short one that Gooch has been waiting for. He makes no mistake again. Placed it ideally there between cover and backward point for four. Dave Gilbert gets a break at this pavilion end and Jeff Lawson comes to take over. Oh, lovely stroke, lent into that again, stroked it through the offside for four more. And again that brings the two batsmen level, both on 72.
Bennett to Gower. That's safe. McDermott the fielder, three more to Gower. Wild throw from McDermott and 2,000 runs in Test cricket against Australia for David Gower. Not many people have done that. This is his 48th innings against Australia.
So England already approaching 200. Going along steadily at about four runs and over.
Too short. It's been the problem with the bowlers for much of the time. Since Lance Lawson has kept the ball up more. Well, that was too short from Bennett. And the 200 comes up from England. 203 for one.
Alan Border using this 15-minute period himself and Murray Bennett to give his quick bowlers an extra rest. But his accuracy's all right, and that's 100 for David Gower. Another Test match century for the England captain, and life is pretty good for him at the moment.
And the 200 partnership coming up in the last over before tea.
Yes, a great partnership and a splendid innings from David Gower to follow on his double century in the Edgbaston Test match. Gooch, 94 not out. He's gone along very well. He's played some crashing drives and one or two very good hook shots as well. Here's the first ball of the second over after tea. Three runs have been added. Graham Gooch is on 97 and McDermott is coming into bowl again.
full pitch, and that's just what Graham Gooch wanted, because that will surely take him to 100. No problem at all. It's over the ropes now. And a great relief for Graham Gooch. Long wait to make his first 100 against Australia. Something of a mystery that it hasn't happened before. But he finally goes to 101 out of 227 for one. 194 balls, 13 fours. His fifth Test 100 in all, but as we've already said many times, this is his first against Australia. McDermott again. Pitch driven quite beautifully again through the covers. No need for anybody to move there. Four runs. So McDermott can't get it right. Either half volleys are too short.
But an exemplary cover drive by Graham Gooch.
Well, we're going to see Kepler Vessels bowl now.
I've seen Kepler Vessels bowl in limited overs games in Australia, where he has to bowl perhaps five of an allotted 10 overs. He's finding it a little tougher out there at the moment. Gow 128 and Gooch 118.
It's an often used phrase, but today the ball has literally gone to all parts. Kepler Vessels is removed from the attack, and Murray Bennett is to return from the Vauxhall end.
Shot. And he's done that extremely well. And that's an improvised stroke. Nonetheless, it went very quickly. So Border has taken off Vessels, his part-time bowler, and brought on his spinner, Murray Bennett, and the result has been the same. Fortunately, this is not the weather for log fires. There's Lawson now preparing to come in from the pavilion end. 288 for one, and Gow's on 129. Magnificent stroke, timing and placement. Well, there's a nice little march. And the bird in the white cap has fixed all that. It's a delightful scene at the moment. No one needing to wear sweaters out there. Packed house, must be something around 19,000 in all, but about 12,500 seats sold. The rest are members. Lawson to Gooch. Once again the slow ball. Up comes the 300 for England for the loss only of Tim Robinson. 134 to Gooch, 135 to Gow. Drop. Kepler Vessels got a hand to it. Lawson's slower bowler was very well bowled. Had Gow playing too soon. Kepler Vessels got his fingertips to it, but it just wouldn't stick.
Bennett again.
that's a short one, which you can't bowl to gooch. With 140 odd on the board, it's four more, 320 up, and that means a 300 partnership. Golden days for English cricket this summer. Lawson then continues round the wicket. Gooch on 147. Well, another fine shot. Excellent way to go through to a 150. 151 for Graham Gooch. Those runs coming out of a total of 328 for one. Gilbert to Gower. Oh, a cracking shot. Gower enjoying that, as indeed the crowd are. So he too goes onto another landmark. 151 out of a 349 for one score. And nothing better seen all day from the bat of Gower. Beautiful cover drive. 20th four. Graham Gooch to face his 162, of course, is his high score ever in a test match. He's got the slow left arm of Bennett to cope with now. Oh, it's a beautiful shot. Just gave himself that little amount of room to pick his spot on the offside.
Graham Gooch has simply taken Murray Bennett apart today. If he puts the fielders on the leg side, he does that and hits the ball through the off. That's in the air.
It's in the air, all right, Bob, but Huddlebert thinks it might have gone for six. But just dropping short of the ropes. The fielder had been back on the boundary. He would certainly have had a good chance of taking the catch. There he goes, all the way back. So back comes McDermott. This time from the far end here, the Vauxhall end.
Court. Murray Bennett, I think it needed two goes to grab it, but he did. It went a terrific pace off the middle of Gower's bat. Bennett caught it at gully, and Craig McDermott has his second wicket. What a marvellous innings from David Gower, fully appreciated by the capacity crowd here at the Oval today. A delightful exhibition.
Great ovation for a great player. David Gower leaves the arena after creating a little bit of history. It's been a marvellous summer for him after he came through that grueling test early in the season. And this is how it all ended. Ball played very firmly into the gully. Murray Bennett, a specialist gully fieldsman, taking at least two attempts to gather it safely. But it hasn't gone back to the turf. And Mike Gatting, for the second test match running, comes in after a very long wait indeed.
89 overs have gone. Last one coming up now, and Murray Bennett to bowl it, and to bowl it to Gatting. And he's caught him. There's some hesitation. Border has given Bennett his first test wicket in England. Porter diving forward to take the catch. And Gatting just waiting to check with Porter that had been caught above the ground, and marches off very, very disappointed. Now the Australians have broken through twice. A lot of runs on the board though. 376 of them. Three wickets down, and Bennett, his first wicket of the day. Very much a case of being thankful for small mercies. That wicket going down towards the end, and Embiri faced five balls without a run being scored. 376 for three, a tremendous batting onslaught from England. 157 in brilliant fashion from Gower, and Gooch going right through the day for 179. The bowling figures tell their own tale, but there is an oddity there. The two new boys, Gilbert and Bennett, between them bowled 44 overs, and the two strike bowlers, Lawson and McDermott, for some reason bowled only 41. Perhaps I can give you an idea of the reason, because the over rate was so slow that the game didn't finish until 46 minutes after the scheduled concluding run from 215 balls. And Gooch, the other hero of the day for England, 295 balls he faced for his 179. No runs have been added.